Hello, once again, a very warm welcome to Star Academy. Today we will explore cognitive development. Cognitive development is the process by which thinking, understanding, and reasoning skills evolve throughout life. Cognitive development is not just about acquiring knowledge, it's about how we use that knowledge to solve problems, make decisions, and learn from our experiences. This growth occurs through interactions with our environment and through biological maturation. Children, for example, think very differently from adults, as their cognitive abilities are still developing. Cognitive development studies help us understand how these mental functions evolve as we age. What is cognitive development? Cognitive development refers to the way our thinking, problem-solving, and understanding of the world evolve over time. It's a critical part of human growth and is closely linked to how we learn, process information, and make decisions. This process begins at birth and continues through adulthood. During early childhood, cognitive development includes skills like recognizing objects, learning language, and understanding cause and effect. As children grow, they start developing more complex abilities, like logical reasoning, critical thinking, and abstract ideas. Jean Piaget, a well-known psychologist, suggested that cognitive development happens in stages. This development is influenced by both nature and nurture, meaning that while genetics play a role, experiences and education are equally important. In the context of education, understanding cognitive development helps teachers create better learning environments, matching lessons to the mental abilities of their students. Cognitive development shapes how we understand the world and adapt to new information throughout life. It's essential in forming our intelligence and problem-solving abilities, which makes it a key focus in both psychology and education. Various theories have contributed to our understanding of cognitive growth. In this video, we will explore theories of cognitive development, factors influencing cognitive development, applications of cognitive development, and finally we will try to conclude our discussion. Key theories of cognitive development are Jean Piaget's Stages of Development, Lev Vygotsky's Sociocultural Theory, Information Processing Theory. Several prominent theories help explain cognitive development. Jean Piaget, for example, proposed that children move through specific stages of development, each characterized by different abilities and ways of thinking. Lev Vygotsky emphasized the role of social interaction and culture in cognitive growth, arguing that learning is a collaborative process. Information processing theory likens the mind to a computer, focusing on how we process, store, and retrieve information. Each theory offers unique insights into how we develop intellectually. Let's now discuss these important theories in detail one by one. Jean Piaget's theory of cognitive development explains how children gradually construct the mental model of the world. His theory is built on four distinct stages, each representing a unique way of thinking and understanding. Let's go through these stages one by one. The first stage is the sensorimotor stage, which lasts from birth to about 2 years. During this period, infants learn through their senses and actions. They begin to understand object permanence, the concept that objects continue to exist even when they are not visible. For example, a baby learns that when a toy is hidden, it still exists. The pre-operational stage in Jean Piaget's theory spans from ages 2 years to 7 years. During this time, children develop the ability to think symbolically. It means they use words, images, and objects to represent things. For example, they might use a stick as a pretend sword, or start forming sentences to express their ideas. However, their thinking is still egocentric. It means they struggle to see things from others' perspectives. They assume that everyone sees and thinks the same way they do. A key challenge in this stage is understanding conservation. This is the idea that quantities, like liquid or objects, stay the same even when their shape or appearance changes. A child might think a taller glass has more water than a shorter one, even if the amount is identical. Overall, the pre-operational stage is about exploring symbols and ideas, but logical thinking hasn't fully developed yet. The third stage in Jean Piaget's theory is concrete operational stage, which occurs from ages 7 years to 11. In this stage, children's thinking becomes more logical and organized, but still focused on concrete objects and events. They can now understand concepts like conservation, realizing that changing the shape of an object doesn't change its quantity. For example, they know that even if you spread out a row of coins, the number remains the same. Children also start to develop decentration, meaning they can consider multiple aspects of a situation rather than focusing on just one. This helps them solve problems in a more logical way. However, their thinking is still tied to real, tangible situations, and they struggle with abstract or hypothetical ideas. Overall, this stage marks significant progress in logical thinking, but it is still grounded in concrete experiences. The fourth stage of Jean Piaget's theory is formal operational stage, which begins around age 12 and continues into adulthood. In this stage, individuals develop the ability to think abstractly and reason logically about hypothetical situations. They can engage in deductive reasoning, meaning they can draw conclusions based on general principles. And they start thinking about possibilities beyond the present moment, like future planning or solving complex problems. They also develop metacognition, the ability to think about their own thinking, which helps them evaluate different solutions and perspectives. This stage allows for understanding abstract concepts like love, justice, and morality, making this period essential for higher-level thinking and critical reasoning. Lev Vygotsky's sociocultural theory emphasizes the crucial role that social interaction and culture play in cognitive development. Unlike Piaget, who believed that development is a solitary process, driven by individual discovery, Vygotsky argued that learning is deeply rooted in social relationships and cultural context. He proposed that children learn best through guided interaction with more knowledgeable others, such as parents, teachers, or peers. One of the core concepts of Vygotsky's theory is the zone of proximal development, or ZPD. The ZPD refers to the range of tasks that a child cannot yet do independently, but can achieve with help. This zone represents the potential for learning, what the child is capable of with guidance. For example, imagine a child trying to solve a puzzle. On their own, they might struggle and give up. However, with a bit of assistance from an adult, such as hints or encouragement, they can solve it. Over time, as they practice, they will be able to do it on their own. Vygotsky saw this support as essential for cognitive development. This leads to the second key point, scaffolding. Scaffolding is the process of providing temporary support to a child to help achieve tasks within zone of proximal development. Think of scaffolding like the temporary structure builders use when constructing a building. In the same way, a teacher or parent provides structured help that is gradually removed as the child becomes more competent. For instance, in the classroom, a teacher might break down a complex task into simpler steps, offering guidance at each stage and slowly reducing the support as the student gains mastery. The third essential element in Vygotsky's theory is the role of language in cognitive development. Vygotsky believed that language is the primary tool of intellectual adaptation. Through language, children not only communicate with others but also begin to internalize knowledge. He introduced the idea of private speech, which is when children talk to themselves while solving problems or learning something new. According to Vygotsky, this self-talk helps them plan, guide their actions, and control their behavior. Over time, this private speech becomes internalized as inner thought, playing a vital role in how we think and process information. In summary, Vygotsky's sociocultural theory emphasizes that learning is a social process, deeply influenced by interaction with others and the cultural context in which one is raised. The zone of proximal development defines the area where learning is most effective with guidance. Scaffolding ensures structured support that leads to independence, and language acts as a critical tool for cognitive development. Vygotsky's theory has had a profound impact on educational practices, stressing the importance of collaborative learning and the role of teachers as facilitators of knowledge, rather than mere transmitters of facts. The information processing theory of cognitive development likens the human mind to a computer, emphasizing how we process, store, and retrieve information. This comparison helps us understand cognitive development as a system of continuous improvement, rather than discrete stages. Just like a computer, the mind takes in information through various inputs, processes it, stores it in memory, and then retrieves it when needed. At the heart of this theory are three key components: attention, memory, and problem solving. Firstly, let's talk about attention. In early childhood, a child's ability to focus on tasks is limited. They might be easily distracted or struggle to maintain concentration. However, as they develop, their attention span increases, allowing them to focus on more complex tasks and process information more effectively. This improved attention is crucial for learning new skills and understanding more complex concepts. Next is memory. Memory plays a vital role in cognitive development. Initially, young children have limited working memory, meaning they can only hold and manipulate a small amount of information at one time. As they grow, their memory capacity expands, enabling them to retain and recall more information. This development is evident in their ability to remember and apply what they've learned over time, whether it's recalling a set of instructions or remembering facts for a test. Lastly, problem-solving skills are central to the information processing theory. Problem-solving involves using stored information to tackle new challenges. As children develop, they become better at organizing their thoughts, planning their actions, and evaluating solutions. For instance, a young child might use trial and error to solve a puzzle, while an older child might use strategies and logical reasoning to find the solution more efficiently. Overall, the information processing theory offers a detailed view of cognitive development by focusing on how we handle information. By comparing the mind to a computer, we can better understand how improvements in attention, memory, and problem-solving contribute to more effective learning and cognitive growth. This perspective highlights the gradual and continuous nature of cognitive development, rather than abrupt changes. Cognitive development is shaped by a variety of factors, each playing a crucial role in how we think, learn, and grow. Let's explore the key influences. Genetics and biology, environment and culture, and education and social interaction. Firstly, genetics and biology, are foundational factors. Our genetic makeup influences cognitive abilities such as memory, problem solving, and attention. Biological factors, including brain structure and function, also play a role. For instance, certain genetic conditions can affect cognitive development, highlighting the importance of our biological heritage in shaping our cognitive capacities. Next is environment and culture, significantly impact cognitive development. The environment in which our children grow up, including their family, community, and cultural context, affects how they learn and develop cognitive skills. Cultural practices and values shape the kinds of knowledge and skills that are emphasized. For example, children raised in cultures that value storytelling might develop strong narrative skills and creativity. Lastly, education and social interaction are critical for cognitive growth. Educational experiences provide structured opportunities for learning, and effective teaching methods can enhance cognitive abilities. Social interactions with peers, teachers, and family members also stimulate cognitive development by exposing children to diverse perspectives and problem-solving strategies. Cognitive development has practical applications in several areas, especially in education, problem-solving, emotional and social skills. Let's explore how these concepts are applied in everyday life. Firstly, in education and learning. Understanding cognitive development helps educators tailor teaching methods to different developmental stages. For example, younger children may need more hands-on activities because their thinking is still concrete, while older students can engage with more abstract concepts. By applying cognitive theories, teachers can create more effective learning environments that promote critical thinking and deeper understanding. Next is problem-solving and decision-making. Problem-solving and decision-making, key aspects of cognitive development. As individuals grow, their ability to process information, analyze situations, and evaluate options improves. Children learn to solve simple problems first, and as they mature, they develop more sophisticated strategies for tackling complex challenges. This growth in cognitive skills is essential not only for academic success but also for making informed decisions in everyday life. Lastly, cognitive development plays a significant role in emotional and social skills. As children mature, they become better at understanding their own emotions and the emotions of others. This helps them develop empathy, regulate their feelings, and interact more effectively in social settings. Cognitive growth enhances their ability to navigate social situations, build relationships, and respond appropriately to various social cues. In conclusion, cognitive development impacts education, problem-solving, decision-making, and social-emotional skills. By applying the principles of cognitive development, we can foster well-rounded growth in children and adults alike, leading to more effective learning, better decision-making, and improved social interactions. With this, we come to the conclusion that cognitive development is essential to the understanding of how we think, learn, and grow throughout life. Cognitive development is a fascinating field that provides insights into the ways humans think and learn. By studying how mental processes evolve, we can better understand ourselves and how to support cognitive growth in others, particularly in education. Whether through Piaget stages, Vygotsky's social interaction model, or information processing theory, each perspective contributes valuable insights to how we develop intellectually. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Take care, and goodbye.